This is JJ. I'm Randall, KravMagaTraining.com. In this video, we're going to go over the defense against bear hug from the front when your arms are tied up. And I'm going to get into the details on proper hand positioning when you're spacing and basing. So this is what I'm talking about. JJ's a bad guy. He bear hugs me with my arms caught. As you guys know, the biggest thing is we need to space and base in order to prevent the bad guy from picking us up. And then our hands are supposed to post here in front of the hips in order to help maintain the space and base position. But there's usually a few mistakes that happen in this position that beginners make when they first learn this. The biggest one is this, is using the thumb sticking out here, using the left thumb. I don't like this because not only do you not have as much control, but it's easy for you to get your thumbs with that injured. So what I'm talking about is beginners will space and base, and they'll do this. So if we turn this way towards the camera, you can see how the thumbs are sticking out like this. This isn't good, all right? So if you don't believe me, here's the thing that you can try on your own. Is do a push-up. At first, try to do a push-up with your hands in this position. It's not that you can't do it, but you're going to feel that it's uncomfortable on your hands, your wrists are shaking, you'll feel unstable, but you can do it. And now just do this. Put your palms on the ground, fingers out, wrist bent. It's way more easy. And then to make it even more challenging, visualize that the floor is shaking up and down like it's an earthquake or it's unstable. You got to remember when the bad guy bear hugs you, his hips aren't necessarily going to be completely flat. You'll be moving around, shaking around during the struggle of the match. And during that, if you have your thumbs sticking out like that, you're going to keep your thumbs bent back. So I want to prevent that possibility for injury. So make sure you're not doing this. Common mistake, people do it all the time, don't even realize it. Thumbs next to here, turn the heels of your palms out and bend your wrist back. Like this. Now the next thing I want to focus on, the exact location of where you're supposed to place your hands. Best thing to do is think about if your partner raises their knee up, where the thigh and hip connect, that front part, that's where you want to place your hands. Right there. Some people go too high. If you go up too like this, his hips are still going to come in towards you. If you go too low, same thing, his hips are going to come right into you. He's going to power through that. So you've got to be on the front of the hip flexors. And the key part is being in the front. Some people make a mistake. They put their hands on the hips like I'm dancing with JJ. I'm not here to dance. I'm here to space and base. My hands are on the sides. They'll power right through that. They'll slide. You've got to bend the wrist back. Put them more in front. So now I have a barrier to stop that. Now some people, because they have wrist injuries or their wrists aren't very flexible, they have a hard time bending their wrist back. So what I suggest is focus on your elbows. Bring your elbows as close as you can, like you have these little T-Rex arms, elbows close next to your body, and it makes it easier to bend your wrist back. The more I flare my elbows out, you see, the less and less I can turn my palms towards the camera. The more I tuck my elbows in, the easier it is, and you don't have to be so flexible with your wrist. So once again, by doing it on JJ, my elbows are flared out. That's as far as I go. As soon as I start tucking my elbows in, keep it close to my body, the easier I can get the heel of my palms on his hips. Also, when my arms are in tight like this, I'm structurally stronger. They're flared like this, he can power through that. My elbows are tucked in tight, it's much more difficult because he has to go through my entire arm. So that's really important too, is keeping the elbows in. And then the last detail is, you can add this to the drill, it's not required, but from this position, you have the option of grabbing material. So here, I have hands on hips if I want to. I can grab onto his pants. Now, I'm not grabbing on the side of the pants. I'm still keeping my wrist bent back like this. So I still have that barrier. But the nice thing about grabbing the pants or the shorts, which can be really natural to do in a stressful situation, is you just have a little bit more control. From here, if he tries to drive into me, I've got a better grip. I also have the option of when I throw a knee strike, I can pull him into me and create a collision. All right, just like I would if I was normally grabbing for knee strikes, I would grab him and pull him down to drive a knee. From here, I grab the material, I can pull in as well. Just make sure that you still keep your wrist bent back and your hands on the front of the hips if you are to grab material. So those are all the little details on the hand positioning. The biggest thing, no thumbs. People do this all the time. Drives me nuts. I'm always worried about people get hurt. Thumbs next to the hands. Fingers out to the sides. Use the front of the heel of the palms. Wrist bent back and tuck your elbows, especially if you have stiff wrists. This is important. Make sure it's on the front of the hips, not the sides. So here's all the details when you space and base. Make sure your hands are in the right spot to maintain the proper space and base position so you can complete the rest of the technique and not get picked up. All right, thank you. See you next video.